Hi there. Well, we're back at Parliament for another year. It's pretty much the beginning of the parliamentary year here in Wellington, and this week we've had the Prime Minister's statement setting out the course for the year, which I think is great. It sets a great tone for where we're going, a clear expectation of what the country needs this year and what we're setting out to deliver. And best of all, I think he's made the election date known. He's set out a very clear programme, and right from the outset, New Zealand's got a very clear choice between what the two major parties are offering. And as we go through the campaign, it will be a very very interesting set of debates we go through. So one of the things, of course, that we'll be talking a lot about over the year is the economy. We're still borrowing $300 million a week, which is a figure that, you know, that scares me. And I'm very much of the view that we have to get our borrowing under control as a country. We have to get back into surplus, and we have to start remembering that, you know, we can't spend a dollar until we earn it. And while there's lots of things that we'd love to be able to go out and invest more money in, if you keep spending before you earn that money, then it's a recipe for failure. So for us, it's very much about keeping a tight control on government spending, making sure that every dollar of taxpayers' funding we spend as if it's our own money, and we make sure we have that same degree of control and care, and making sure we get the best bang for buck with all taxpayers' dollars. And that's why we're seeing a need to look at the public service and make sure it really is delivering the sort of outcomes we want for New Zealanders. You know, the fact that we can now say we're achieving 20,000 more elective surgeries every year than under Labour. The fact that we're prioritising the fact that we need our kids to be able to read and write. It's not good enough for 12,000 children every year to leave school without having the maths and literacy skills they need to get ahead in life, and that's something that we're absolutely focused on. And in early childhood education, we're committing more money than ever before, $1.4 billion. Now, you might have heard some talk about cuts in the sector. Let me tell you what's going on. What we've decided to do is take away the top end rate of subsidy for childcare centres with between 80 and 100% teachers. But importantly, any money we'd save from that is going into ensuring that more children have access to early childhood education. Because what we were seeing was that while the funding had tripled, in fact, rates of participation had only gone up by less than 1%. So for us, what's really important is that almost every New Zealand child has access to good quality ECE. So we're redirecting that money into more participation. Those are the sort of outcomes that we want for New Zealand. But in this time of tight financial control and the need to make sure that we very carefully spend the money till we get back to surplus, we're having to make some fairly strong decisions around those issues. Let me talk a bit about something else that's happening this year, which is the MMP referendum. Same time as the general election this year, we'll all have the chance to say what we think of our electoral system. Do we like MMP? Do we want to go back to first past the post? Or what about supplementary member or preferential voting? There are some really interesting decisions to be made in this, and there are some interesting consequences it has for all of our system. For example, how big are our electorates? How many people should represent us from each electorate? Should we have list MPs? If we do have them, how should they be chosen? How many of them should there be? Do we want a small party being able to have the balance of power? Do we like the fact that there's a wider representation of groups in Parliament? So there's going to be a really interesting lot of debates around this. And the one message I want people to have is to get out there and have this debate, talk about it over the teacups, and really focus on what sort of electoral system we want for this country going forward. So finally, I guess for me, it's February this month, and so like a number of my colleagues, I've signed up to do FebFast, which is a program where we give up alcohol for the month of February, get people to sponsor us, and then that money goes to drug and alcohol treatment programs for young New Zealanders. And I think so far the National Party teams raised just shy of $3,000, so we're going well. So far, so good. I'm actually enjoying my month. Perhaps I'll stick with it a bit longer. So anyway, New Zealand, I hope you're all going well. If you haven't been down to Selwyn recently, come down and see us. It's a beautiful part of the country, and this time of year, it's just spectacular. That's all from me. Catch you again soon.